up y'all, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to do this video. I thought about doing this video last night. I was on the computer and it just came to me like an epiphany. I was just like, I want to do a video talking about things I would tell my younger self. And I feel like this video would help maybe like some younger people. Of course, I'm 32, so I feel like I have a good amount of, you know, things that I went through to give, you know, a little advice to you. Maybe somebody who's about, you know, teenagers or 18, 19 or younger 20s or something like that. I feel like these tips will probably help somebody. And even if you're not, you know, young and you're still going through some stuff, I feel like these tips will kind of help out. So I want to name this video Things I Will Tell My Younger Self, okay? So I wrote down 5 things that I would tell my younger self. Let me get my notebook so I don't forget. But I wrote down five things that I would tell my younger self. Now the first thing, I wrote down was, do not overpluck your brows. Be good to them. It makes you look younger. Because as you already know, fuller brows make you look younger. I used to pluck the hell out of my eyebrows, y'all. I used to pluck my eyebrows until I damn near didn't have none. And I look at old pictures, I'm just like, girl, you didn't have no eyebrows. I mean, like, none. Like, they was just, like, damn near transparent. It's just crazy. Like, I damn near didn't have no eyebrows. They were just thin as hell. And my forehead already big as hell. So I'm like, why were you plucking up all your eyebrows? I mean, come on now. You should have just been good to them. So, yeah, just be good to your eyebrows, because once you overpluck them, it's harder to grow back. And I'm telling you, it's hard to have your eyebrows grow back. And I think I had a pretty good set of eyebrows when I was younger, but not no more. I can't grow a good eyebrow to save my life now. Okay, so the next thing I wrote down was embrace your body, stop comparing. Everybody is different. Everybody's body is different. And I know I used to like always compare myself. Like growing up, I was always like super skinny. I was super skinny. I was like 80 pounds up until high school, I want to say. I was like super, super skinny. And I would always want like the curves, you know, everybody had like, I felt like everybody had like the small waist and the big butt and the hips and the thighs and all that. And I'm just walking around here looking like a broom, looking like a broomstick with a head popped on it. Like I was just skinny as hell. But I always would compare myself. So I would just say, just stop doing that. Just embrace your body. I mean, everybody is different. Everybody's not built to have like a hourglass figure. Everybody's not built like that. So I would definitely go back and tell myself, be good to your body. I was never anorexic or nothing like that, or bulimia. I would eat, like I would always eat, like, but I just could never really gain weight. So yeah, just be good to yourself. Don't worry about, you know, trying to gain weight to look good for somebody else, or just try to look like the Instagram models. Just be good to yourself. Embrace what you have. I promise you, your older self would appreciate it. Now, another thing that I would definitely tell somebody, now I know this will probably help somebody, that you don't even have to be younger, but save your money. Every time you get paid, put some money away. Always put some money away. I don't care if it's $20. If you're not making that much money, girl, trust me, I understand. But put a little bit of money away. If it's $20 a paycheck, $50 a paycheck, the more you can put away, the better. $5 a paycheck, whatever you can put away and save. Just start a saving. At first, it's gonna be like, okay, well, I don't have no money in these savings. But the more you stick to it, you're gonna start building up that money. And sooner or later, you're gonna be looking at your savings, and your savings gonna be looking better than your checking. Like, just make sure you put money away, you know, just in case. And plus, if you wanna go out of town or something, and somebody say, hey, you know, I'm going on a trip, you got some money for that. And even if you're not saving for something in particular, but just save something anyway, just in case you have something come up. You may have some car trouble, because trust me, you can have some car trouble. Like, you might need some tires, or you might need an oil change, and depending on what kind of car you got, the oil change is gonna run you a good $65-$70, probably, if not more than that, depending on what kind of car you got. But yeah, just make sure you always have some money saved, put away, just in case. Another thing I would go back and tell my younger self is to speak up for yourself. Don't just let people just say whatever they wanna say. Because over the years, I feel like the older that I get, the more I don't give a fuck. Like, I just, the older I get, the less I just care. I just really don't really care about a lot of stuff. And I know I've always been kind of nonchalant, but the older I get, I feel like it's just grew to the point where I really don't care about damn near nothing. That's not in my immediate life. But yeah, I would definitely go back and tell my younger self, don't let people talk to you any kind of way. Don't just let people say slick stuff and not say nothing about it. If you feel like it's shade, then just say something. You know, if something is bothering you, make sure you voice your opinion and let it be known that you feel a certain type of way about it. You don't have to be rude about it. You know, it's always, I always say, it's a way to say anything. You can say anything to anybody. It just depends on how you say it. So just, if something is bothering you, speak your mind. You don't have to be like, okay, well, you don't have to be popping your neck or nothing like that. But, you know, just let it be known that, okay, I just feel like this is wrong. Just, you know, just let it be known that something is bothering you. Now, my last thing is something that I've been working on this for, like the past couple of years now, and I'm actually really proud of where I took my credit. But make sure you have your credit in order. Don't take your credit for granted. Don't just go out there and get all these credit cards and all this stuff. Now, when I was younger, I didn't have like all these credit cards and nothing like this. Thankfully, I didn't go out and get like a bunch of credit cards. But with some bills, I was just like, okay, well, if I don't pay them, they can just put it on my credit. I mean, I don't care. I ain't worried about it right now. But just keep your credit in mind, because once you get older, of course, you're going to want to get more stuff. You may want to go out there and buy yourself a car, or you may want to go and get yourself a house. And you don't want to just, you don't want to be a certain age and you can't get nothing on your credit, and then you have to go ask your mama or your cousin or your sister or just anybody else in your life. I'm like, well, can you put this, I'm trying to get a house. Can you put this house in your name? You know, and people ain't going to be like, well, sure, I'll put a house in my name for you. Ain't nobody going to be doing that. You know, just keep that in mind. Just make sure you take care of your credit. If you have any bills, pay them. And let me know if you want me to do a video telling you how I built up my credit, because I have been working on my credit for like the past couple of years, and I build my credit up so much, and I'm so proud of myself for doing that. But yeah, let me know if you want to see me do a video about that. But yeah, just make sure you pay your bills. If you have to start off with like a little small credit card, don't max out the credit card. Use like a little small amount. Make sure you make your payments every month and do that. But just don't go out there maxing out your credit card. Don't just go crazy with your credit, because you have to pay this stuff back. You know what I'm saying? So you just only get what you can afford to pay. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so that is pretty much it. These are some tips and some advice that I would tell to my younger self if I had like a little young person in my life to where I can give this advice to. This is what I would tell whoever that is. All these tips. Love yourself. Take care of yourself. Take care of your credit. Make sure you save money. Don't go out there depending on people. Don't do that. And just, you know, just live life. Don't just go through life worrying about simple stuff like, oh, well, I don't look like so-and-so. Or, you know, just don't worry about little stuff like that. Love yourself. Take care of yourself. And everything will be all right. I promise you, when you get older, you'll look back and be like, you know what? I did pretty good for myself. But anyway, that's it. Thank y'all so much for watching this video. If you have any other requests or any other videos that you want me to do, just let me know down below in the comments, and I will be sure to get that done. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank y'all for watching, and I will see you on my next one. Bye.